That's closeness to the customer is key, in especially in our line of business, because you're dealing with people's emotions.
If a client has got a windscreen claim, how long does it take for it to be settled? And we've come up with a turnaround time of, let's say, 7 days, that might be sorted out.
Our vision is to be the model broker for Africa.
1951. As Kenya struggled for her independence, the dreams of East Africa's best and leading insurance broker, Eagle Africa Insurance Brokers Limited, was born. Registered as Hogg Robinson and Capel Insurance Brokers of UK in 1951, the company has undergone transition and name changes. In 1994, the company changed name to Bain Hogg Insurance Brokers following a global acquisition, and then to Alexander Forbes Insurance Brokers in 2000. Then the leading brokerage firm in Kenya, the company changed name to Eagle Africa Insurance Brokers Limited to fulfill its ambition of spreading its wings to cover East Africa in line with the East Africa integration between East Africa economies in Tanzania and Uganda.
Eagle Africa is aiming to be the model broker for Africa, and this is aimed to be achieved hopefully before the end of this year. We've got a roadmap for the next 5 years where we will be the talking point of everyone, and we'll be in everyone's lips in the next 5 years.
In addition to growth in East Africa, the company has expanded within Kenya in line with the changed system of government, devolution.
The initiative of us moving to Meru was spearheaded because of maybe two aspects. One, the opening of the North Corridor. It's really our main focus to be part of the team that will be within that region as it grows. Secondly, the discovery of oil, minerals, oil and gas within Isiolo. It is one of the key focus for us, that there will be a lot of business potential, and the more reason we are going to Meru County.
Thought of going to Kitengela first, and the next port of call is going to be Thika Road. Whether we're going to also look at Naivasha Road, I do not know, but that's not in the immediate plans. But yes, the devolution is one of the reasons why we've gone to the counties. But also, we have paid attention to the areas that are growing economically very, very, very quickly.
This, with the name of being the leading brokerage firm in Africa by 2018, Eagle Africa's sheer determination and daring to venture like the eagles where no one dares has yielded more results and tremendous growth.
In 2000, the company earned income worth around 160 million Kenyan shillings. This has gone up to around 520 million in 2012. This, in average, is a growth of 12% per annum. The company has been able to acquire its own premises where we sit now.
Kenya's insurance penetration stands at an alarming 3.1%. This, compared with the tens of players already fighting for this percentage, combined with new players coming in, has rendered the industry a scramble by all, characterized by undercutting, where players duplicate each other's products, resulting in lack of innovation. Eagle Africa Insurance Brokers, however, has grown in bounds to be the leading innovator of new products. According to the Chief Executive Officer, Sam Cherry, innovation is a key to opening the market and increase access to insurance services for all Kenyans.
What has accelerated our growth is product innovation and the level of service that we offer to our clients.
In working on new products, currently we've actually about to roll two products. One is what you're calling the marine open cover with clearing and forwarding agents. We've realized we can only tap business through the source. You know, in marine and cargo transportation, a lot of the business is handled by clearing and forwarding agents. So we've entered into partnership to develop a product between Eagle Africa and clearing and forwarding agents.
We've just come up with a motor cover for the senior citizens. where you find that we are rewarding them for their integrity in driving. So whereas we know the standard motor rates in the market, here we are saying these people drive very well, so we need to reward them, and the way to reward them is to make sure that they pay cheaper rates, and that you come in when somebody is 55 years and above.
Traditionally, we were doing what we call medical insurance broking, but you have since changed that to healthcare consulting. Yeah, by consulting, it means that we are closer now to our clients and understand their needs and package them to the best of our ability to ensure that we respond to the healthcare insurance needs.
For example, Mbao Pension Plan, where lower income informal sector earners are able to save for the future, has amassed regional success that has seen the innovation replicated in South Africa and is now being tested in 5 other East African countries by the World Bank.
It's a product that has excited a lot of people, and as many as 6 countries have come to this country to look at it. It has got a full backing of the World Bank, and the World Bank is actually saying they will match shilling for shilling. For every shilling that is contributed by the member of the scheme, he'll give a shilling. So if you save two shillings, World Bank will give you another 2 shillings. So your saving ends up being 4 shillings.
In 2012, we came up with our students' accident cover. This is a very, very superior product, because we realize that we have a gap. When students are injured, you kind of find the learning institutions don't know what to do. A child is injured, you can't get the parent, so what do you do with the child? And we felt that this is one way that the schools can get themselves exposed to liability claims with the parents.
So what makes Eagle Africa a watershed organization?
We are about the only insurance broker in the country who's got a full-time training director. And there's a suggestion to convert our training department into an insurance university.
What does Eagle Africa do that is so unique to other companies?
We are unique in the sense that we are never in a hurry to deal with a client.
Our claims documentations and claim response must be done within 24 hours to customers, and that goes a long way to increase the efficiency levels, which basically now turns out to what we call good customer service.
We have to stay very close to our customers. Remember, medical is very people sensitive. We are dealing with people's emotions. Somebody has gone to hospital, they've been admitted. On the third day, when the bill has hit $500,000, and they've been told by the insurance company the claim is not payable. You must have ways and means of communicating that information to that specific customer.
Out there, we are known as one organization that upholds integrity and professionalism in everything that we do. It is very difficult doing business in Kenya today, but this organization is one that will never take things under the carpet. So we pride ourselves in that, and our staff know what is expected of them, and we stand for that. We'd rather gain a small business through professional and ethical practices than gain a big business through unethical and corrupt practices.
To achieve this, the company is structured in several divisions, namely international and marine, life and pension, finance, elite clients, medical and express divisions, that are all headed by directors whose innovation has continued to place Eagle Africa on the global scale.
What we've done essentially is split our business into corporate accounts and into individual accounts. Now, under the corporate schemes, we either place the corporate with an insurance company or offer third-party administration services, what I said earlier. Yeah, and another individual, we either place with the insurance company or also look for another solution by selling or placing the individual in the national market, depending again on the need of the client.
At Eagle Africa, the consumer is always the king. We ensure that the customer's needs come first and that they are never held back by risk. The journey to where Eagle Africa is hasn't been easy. There has been lots of speculation in Kenya on the benefits of using an insurance broker, but as the chief executive explains, an insurance broker is inevitable.
Insurance broker is an insurance consultant. And the insurance broker is the professional in insurance. So the role of the broker actually is to act as a consultant for the client. And he is one who understands what the needs of the clients are. The underwriter issues a policy based on what has been presented by the broker.
As Eagle Africa celebrates over 63 years of excellence and with a mission that parades to the customer's comfort, dependability, and reliability, one cannot help wonder the human resource that makes all this a success.
We have a sound recruitment policy in place, and that is how we are able to attract that talent. Because for an organization to be able to achieve its business strategy or business agenda, then you have to have the right people on board. And having a sound recruitment policy is very important to guide you into getting that talent that is out there.
However, having the right staff does not guarantee success. It's the ability to motivate, to train, and to equip the human resource to be world-class, competing at international standards.
Money is not the only motivator. You leave people to do what you have assigned them to do without meddling too much. Now, of course, if they don't do what they're supposed to do, you light a little bit of fire under their feet. And then that keeps them agile and motivated. But most important of all, you keep staff informed of what is happening in the company, and you keep the vision in front of them at all times.
In tandem with our culture and heritage, we believe Eagle Africa Insurance Brokers Limited is the organization that will ensure your growth is uninterrupted. We'll grow with you because our mandate is to be a stepping stone anchoring you to achievement of your own organizational goals, your success. Eagle Africa Insurance Brokers Limited. Venture where eagles dare.